subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Odisha got soaked in spirituality as it observed the most auspicious Jagannath Rath Yatra or Chariot Festival. One of the biggest and widely celebrated occasions of India, it is celebrated with much fanfare in different parts of the country, but the one held in Puri is just beyond comparison. Though this year amid coronavirus pandemic, the grandeur was not to the match of previous years, but still the festive spirit was maintained and administration kept a keen eye upon the whole event.
The beach town of Puri got filled with numerous colours as it celebrated the world-famous Jagannath Rath Yatra, dedicated to Lord Jagannath, his sister Goddess Subhadra and his elder brother Lord Balbhadra. Placed on huge decorative chariots, the three deities were moved to Gundicha Temple, said to be the abode of Lord Jagannath's aunt, where they will remain for the span of 9 days and later they will come back to the Jagannath Temple. Though the event witnesses more than 1.5 million devotees' participation, but this year, public attendance was disallowed by the country's Apex Court earlier this month amid concerns of coronavirus spread in the country, which appears to be at its peak. However, it permitted the authorities to conduct the traditional Rath Yatra with necessary curbs.
We have done a very good arrangement for the Rath Yatra. This is a balance between allowing a full Rath Yatra and not allowing Rath Yatra at all. So we found a midway, Honorable Court found a midway that the Rath Yatra will be conducted but without participation of bhaktas.
Under the supervision of Odisha State Administration, a curfew was also imposed in Puri city during the festivities. Moreover, the COVID-19 test of 700 priests who pulled the three chariots in Rath Yatra were also conducted. The administration even maintained the records of all the participants in the processions, as only servitors and priests are allowed, along with the details of their medical conditions after testing. Though there were tough restrictions, but the priest as well as other people were happy that at least the festival was not cancelled, and they believe that Lord will help the country to get rid of this menace of coronavirus.
अभी चालू हुआ है अभी करोना फरोना कुछ नहीं रहेगा वो बाद में बाहर से आने से सब करोना टूट जाएगा कोई विश्वास है मेरा विश्वास है हेलने से तो हम बोला कि जरूर रथ चलाएगा ऐसे राजा कबड़ी का पास हम बोला का जरूर रथ चलेगा।
हम लोग घर से दर्शन कर रहे हैं, बहुत सौभाग्य की बात है कि ये यहाँ पे इतना अच्छा, कल तक डिसीजन नहीं, सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने लिया था कि रथयात्रा नहीं होगा तो हम सब उदास थे, पर अचानक से फिर से सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने अपना डिसीजन बदला और यहाँ पे रथयात्रा पूरी तरीके से, जैसे हर साल अच्छे तरीके से, अनोखे तरीके से होता है, इस साल भी हो रहा है।
द ओरिजिन ऑफ जगन्नाथ्स आइडल इज द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ मेनी टेल्स। It is believed that King Indra Yumna, who ruled from Ujjain in Madhya Pradesh, according to Hindu scriptures, had a vision that the body of Krishna will float up to the shores of Puri, post which he should build statues of Krishna, Balram and Subhadra. The dream came true when King found the mortal remains and then carved them in the hollow of wooden idols. The idols of Krishna, Balram and Subhadra were installed successfully in the temple, and since then, a massive procession is carried out every year with these statues in three big chariots.
The COVID-19 pandemic has united the whole country into one family, whose each and every member is contributing its bit to sail through these hard times. But a few among them have just changed the definitions of compassion and empathy with their extraordinary efforts and have become an inspiration for all. One among them is the members of a charitable organization, Mercy Mission in Bengaluru, who have stepped in to give COVID-19 victims a dignified send-off, no matter which caste or community they belong to. Have a look.
COVID-19 has posed several challenges before the country, among which performing the last rites of the patients who succumbed to the disease is the major one. In many cases, the family of a deceased is in quarantine itself, while in few the family may not be willing to accept the body of the patient as the contamination levels are too high and there are even chances of fatal infection if not handled with care. In such a situation, volunteers from Mercy Mission, a Bengaluru-based charitable organization that was launched about 4 months back, have stepped in to give COVID-19 victims a dignified send-off. Led by Dr. Taha Mateen, who is also the head of the HBS hospital in Bengaluru, these volunteers, famously known as Mercy Angels, have been working relentlessly to perform the last rites of those killed by the infectious disease. Irrespective of the caste and community of the deceased, they perform the last rites and never let the religious barriers come in the way of their duty.
Well, I think COVID, number one, and death has brought everybody together. There is no dead Muslim, dead Hindu, dead Christian. Everybody is the same, right? So yes, this is about coming over all those barriers of race and citizenship and class and religions and all these artificial barriers we have created between human beings. I think COVID has united us all, put everybody together and has given a loud voice. Hey, human beings, get together. At the end of the day, we are all human. So we respect people's religions. We respect their individual feelings. You want to be buried in this way, we help you out. You want to be buried in this way or cremated in this way, we help it out. It is not for us to tell you what the correct thing is, this is right or that. You want this, I will help you in that.
The team has a dedicated ambulance and practices high hygiene standards while dealing with the bodies. They wear personal protective equipments and sanitize their vehicles and equipment every time. Though the task is risky, but Mercy Angels remain undeterred in their efforts to serve the society.
I am here from last 25 years in a medical field. We know the consequences, what are the virus, what is the this thing and all. since I am in the lab in charge. Okay? And for a second thought of that, when we are doing a good thing, things, why we should be scared?
Rising above religious biases and working with only motive to serve the humanity, this is what the Mercy Angels have been doing. Their work is inspiration for everyone to come forward and help the country at this time of need.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched a scheme for the coronavirus hit poor to improve livelihood opportunities for the poor migrants in rural areas. The Garib Kalyan Rojgar Abhiyan or Poor Development Employment Campaign was launched through video conferencing in New Delhi.
हमारा प्रयास है कि इस अभियान के जरिए श्रमिकों और कामगारों को घर के पास ही काम दिया जाए। अभी तक आप अपने हुनर और मेहनत से शहरों को आगे बढ़ा रहे थे, शहरों को चमका रहे थे, शहरों का भला कर रहे थे। अब अपने गांव को, अपने इलाके को आगे बढ़ाएंगे।
In the past months, workers were seen walking long distances to their homes after they were left without work as Modi imposed a vast lockdown in March to control the spread of coronavirus, shutting down all public transport. While addressing ministers and beneficiaries, Modi said the manner in which Indian villagers fought coronavirus had taught a lesson to the cities.
India's first mobile laboratory for COVID-19 testing is ready to make a move to the rural and inaccessible areas of India. Launched recently by the Indian Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan, such efforts have been put in to ensure testing facilities in far-flung areas. The laboratory has the capability to perform 25 RT-PCR and 300 ELISA tests per day, along with additional tests of TB and HIV as per the central government's health scheme rules.
This bus can move around across the country in interior smallest towns of the city. Country and you can get the blood testing done. So this bus is equipped with the latest equipment. All those equipments which Dr. Lal or big hospitals or big government hospitals have are already fitted in this lab, and you can perform basic tests for COVID patients to find out whether how many people have been infected by COVID.
The mobile laboratory is being seen as a great step towards addressing the shortage of critical healthcare technologies in the country and moving towards the stage of self-sufficiency.
India has been converting a spiritual center located in New Delhi into what it claims will be the world's biggest temporary hospital with 10,000 beds to treat a surge in number of COVID-19 cases. Dozens of beds have been placed in the Radha Swami Spiritual Center, including one made out of cardboard.
ये बहुत ही बड़ा स्पेस है, ऑलरेडी शेडेड है और इसमें हम वेरियस पार्टीशंस करके कई इंक्लोजर्स बना सकते हैं और उसमें हम ये प्रयास कर रहे हैं कि इसको एक अराउंड 10,000 बेडेड कैपेसिटी के मेकशिफ्ट हॉस्पिटल में कन्वर्ट कर सकें।
India has been taking a number of steps to battle against COVID-19, which is slowly yielding positive results.
Amid the worldwide race to discover a drug to treat COVID-19, Indian yoga guru Baba Ramdev has made the sensational claim to have developed the first Ayurvedic medicine against the coronavirus. Coronil and Swasari Ayurvedic medicine that was launched recently by his company Patanjali is claimed to have shown 100% favorable results during clinical trials on affected patients.
क्लिनिकल केस स्टडी के अंदर हमने 280 रोगियों को सम्मिलित किया और वहाँ क्लिनिकल केस स्टडी का रिजल्ट भी अपने आप में अप्रतिम था। उसमें भी 100% पेशेंट्स की रिकवरी हुई, एक भी डेथ नहीं हुई और सिम्टोमेटिक ट्रीटमेंट से लेकर के सिस्टमिक ट्रीटमेंट से लेकर के माने कोरोना और कोरोना के जो कॉम्प्लिकेशंस थे उन सबको एक साथ हम कंट्रोल कर पाए।
सो फार द क्लेम्स ऑफ बाबा रामदेव हैव नॉट बीन वेरीफाइड बाय एनी साइंटिफिक कम्युनिटीज नॉर देयर इज एनी साइंटिफिक एविडेंस ऑफ एनी काइंड ऑफ अल्टरनेटिव मेडिसिन क्योरिंग कोरोना वायरस। हाउएवर रामदेव सेड द मेडिसिन वाज प्रिपेयर्ड बाय द कंबाइंड एफर्ट्स ऑफ हिज पतंजलि रिसर्च सेंटर एंड मेडिकल एंड पैरामेडिकल नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मेडिकल साइंसेज यूनिवर्सिटी बेस्ड आउट ऑफ वेस्टर्न राजस्थान स्टेट।
New Delhi will transform 500 railway coaches into facilities equipped to care coronavirus patients in order to cope with a surge in cases in the national capital that has led to a shortage in hospital beds. The coaches equipped with 3 oxygen cylinders per carriage will increase Delhi's capacity by 8,000 beds, Union Home Minister Amit Shah said on Twitter after meeting with capital's chief minister.
इस कोच के अंदर एक कोच के अंदर 2 टॉयलेट 2 वॉशरूम्स हैं, इसके अलावा डस्टबिन्स हैं और इसमें 3 ऑक्सीजन सिलेंडर इस कोच में हैं अगर किसी ज़रूरत पड़ती है। लेकिन इन कोचेज़ के अंदर माइल्ड जिनके सिम्टम्स हैं उन्हीं को रखने के लिए इसके लिए प्रोविजन है।
Trained coaches are already being used as isolation wards in various parts of the country and are playing a major role in containing the virus.
Coronavirus pandemic has disrupted the lives of people across the globe, but it has also given us a number of stories of extraordinary kindness where people cutting across all religious barriers have just worked for the sake of humanity. One such story that recently came into limelight is from the Mumbai city of Maharashtra, where 2 youngsters are providing oxygen tanks to patients as COVID-19 cases continue to rise.
Amid rising coronavirus cases in the country, the deficit in number of oxygen cylinders is emerging as another big issue. To overcome this problem, 2 youngsters, Shahnawaz Hussain and Abbas Rizvi from Mumbai, have come forward to provide free oxygen cylinders to both coronavirus as well as other patients with respiratory problems in the city. The idea first came to Abbas when he lost his 6-month pregnant relative due to the unavailability of oxygen support. So, realizing the problems that people could be facing without oxygen support, he decided to start this service, in which he was joined by his friend Shahnawaz, who sold his SUV car to meet the growing demand of the cylinders. Presently, both the friends have been supplying oxygen cylinders to every needy person, irrespective of his status, caste and community.
अभी तो जो सभी तरह के लोग आ रहे हैं, अमीर भी आ रहे हैं, गरीब भी आ रहे हैं, हम लोग कोई भेदभाव नहीं कर रहे, हिंदू भी आ रहे हैं, मुस्लिम भी आ रहे हैं, हम लोग किसी का नाम नहीं पूछ रहे हैं। बस आपको ज़रूरत है, आप डॉक्टर से रिकमेंडेशन लिखा के लाइए, सिलेंडर ले जाइए।
As of now, the duo has supplied around 300 oxygen cylinders. Every day they lent around 10 to 15 cylinders that are provided free of cost for the duration of 48 hours. People are effusive in their praises for the duo, who are available 24/7 to help them.
मेरी मम्मी को कैंसर है गले में, तो उनका जो ये गला है वो ब्लॉक हो गया, तो उनको सांस लेने नहीं हो रहा। अब डॉक्टर ने बोला उनको ऑक्सीजन कंपलसरी है, तो कहीं से एडजस्ट नहीं हुआ, तो ये भाई का नंबर मिला तो यहाँ से एडजस्ट हुआ है। अभी थर्ड टाइम मैं लेके जा रहा हूँ यहाँ से।
Amid the pandemic, a number of examples like Shahnawaz and Abbas have come forward who have not just set an example of kindness, but in some way have also helped in strengthening the country's secular fabric by helping the needy people irrespective of their faith.
Considered being around 5,000 year old, mental, physical and spiritual practice, yoga does not just change the way we see things, it transforms the person who sees it. In order to carry forward this rich Indian legacy, every year 21st June is observed as International Yoga Day all over the world after the initiative was taken by a Prime Minister. This year, amid virus outbreak, citizens preferred celebrating the occasion at their home, adhering to social distancing norms. Have a look.
The science of yoga plays a crucial role in improving physical, mental, emotional and spiritual health of humans. This ancient form of meditative and physical exercise that originated in India has now gained recognition worldwide. Every year, June 21 is observed as the International Yoga Day across the world to celebrate this invaluable gift of India's ancient tradition. This year marked the 6th International Yoga Day that was observed in India with the theme Yoga at Home, Yoga with Family amid coronavirus pandemic.
Yoga enhances our quest for a healthier planet. It has emerged as a force for unity and deepens the bonds of humanity. It does not discriminate. It goes beyond race, color, gender, faith, and nations. Anybody can embrace yoga.
Beating all odds, the ITBP personnel in the northern region of Ladakh perform yoga asanas to celebrate the occasion. Wrapped up with thick jackets and woolen caps to beat the chill in the region, the jawans were seen performing pranayam and Surya Namaskar with great discipline. The enthusiasm was no less among the CRPF personnel in Jammu as well. They perform yogasana and meditative activities collectively to spread the message of yoga, which is to come together.
नियमित रूप से योगा वगैरह हम लोग कराते रहते हैं और आज पूरे विश्व में योगा दिवस मनाया जा रहा है, तो हमने भी इसको ऑर्गेनाइज किया है। ये कोविड के चलते हुए सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग का ध्यान रखा गया है। जितना भी हमारे पास स्पेस था, जितना भी हमारे पास मैन पावर है, ये कोशिश किया गया है कि जितना भी डिस्टेंस हो सकता था वो कराया जा रहा है।
A grant level event was organized at Patanjali Yogpeeth Trust in Haridwar city of Uttarakhand, where the yoga guru Baba Ramdev, along with hundreds of people, performed a number of breathing exercises and poses to give way to a healthy and holistic lifestyle. Meanwhile, in Amritsar city, people were seen performing yoga at their homes in order to adhere to social distancing norms and avoid going out.
हमारा शरीर सुंदर रहे, मन सुंदर रहे, तन सुंदर रहे। योग हमें ना शरीर रूप से शुद्ध करता है, मानसिक रोगों से भी बचाता है, और हम फैमिली मेंबर्स, क्योंकि कोविड की वजह से हम बाहर नहीं जा सकते, घर में बैठ के मोदी जी के साथ टीवी पे योगा करना आज सुबह से।
For centuries, India has been a mystical land of meditation and enlightenment where spiritual traditions flourished and still continue to inspire, and yoga is one among them. At present, when the country is battling with coronavirus, yoga can prove as the best remedy to boost our immunity and keep the virus at bay.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@nin.com. I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.